One of the most popular videos that we have, it's about pronation. You know, it's a pretty hot topic, but it's at the same time a topic that creates so much confusion on the tennis community. You know, like we have all these comments on the past videos, like, oh, it's like you guys are talking so much about pronation on flat serve or a kick serve, but what about a slice? You shouldn't be pronating on a slice. You know, it's like, well, right, we're doing this video so we can clarify a few of these topics and make it a little bit simpler for you. Okay, so first of all, very simple, what's pronation? If you think about it, and we're trying to keep it simple, at the end of the day, if we're keeping our arm neutral here and we are turning it this way, this is called pronation. This could be called supination when we are turning it towards the right, right? Obviously on the left side would be the opposite. Pronation could be like an inside turn. Supination would be an outside turn. So if I put my racket in, it could be the same thing, right? If I'm pronating, I would be turning this way. I'm supinating from neutral, always start from neutral, okay? I'm supinating, I could be moving this way. Now, if we think about it, when we add it to a serve, it's like, just think about it, how are we going upwards on the serve? If you have a normal, professional serve motion, you could be going upwards here, going up with the edge of the racket, right? So if you think about it, is my arm neutral here, or this is already supinated here? Well, if you think about it and I relax my arm, do you see how it turns forward? Now, if I'm here and I relax my arm, look what's gonna happen with the racket. Do you see? My arm is neutral right now. If we go back here, boom, this is back to neutral. Okay, so if you think about it, as soon as we start the motion upwards and the racket drops back, so if we go up with the edge of the racket, hopefully you don't go this way, okay, because you are already pronated, you will be going on a pretty much a supination mode up here. Why? Because the edge of the racket is going up on the motion, right? So even if you are not finishing with the racket facing a little more towards the side, if you think about it, you are already pronating, okay? So the motion from here to here, that's already called pronation. Now, what's the next question? It's like, oh, should we actually finish with the racket towards the side on a slice serve? Well, the answer is yes. If you check professional players in slow motion, whenever they hit the slice, they are here, hit the slide, and then they pronate, okay? But it's a continuous motion, especially if you don't slow down a little bit the rhythm, it's almost impossible for you to see it. Why? Because they hit it here. If it's a slice, well, that's a terrible ball, but yeah, here, if you think about it, you are hitting, then you are relaxing, so by the time they finish, they look that the arm is looking this way, but at the end of the day, when you are hitting that ball, you are actually pronating, okay? So, very, very important, especially on kick serves and flat serves. Why? Pronation, it's an extra motion that adds the racket more racket head speed. So if you're working on something like racket head speed, working on pronation could be extremely important. Why? Because if you're trying to hit the ball harder, but you're here and you stop the racket here, what happens? You're missing that last extra motion of the forearm really like accelerating this way. Okay, and that's why then it gets with the other hot topic that we have on the surface, like should you flip your wrist? The answer is no, you should be pronating instead. Now, if you look at professionals, it looks like they flip the wrist a lot of times, right? Well, they really don't. The thing is, they're hitting the ball, they look super relaxed, and after they hit, the arm is so relaxed that the wrist, after they pronate, is actually flipping this way. Okay, so you hit, you're coming this way, point of contact with the ball, you keep going, the arm keeps pronating, as I told you, and then once you're here, they flip the wrist. Why? Look at my motion here. It's because I'm relaxed. I'm barely holding the racket. If you are holding it a little too tight, first of all, it's gonna be hard for you to pronate. And second, you are not gonna be able to use the wrist. If you are using the wrist, chances are you're gonna end up getting injured because your wrist doesn't have power, okay? The wrist is obviously not a muscle, okay? Right here, you're not gonna have much power going this way. It's good for control, it's good for accuracy, but this is not gonna work as adding more power on the ball, okay? So before we're done with the video, I wanna show you a couple of slicers where I'm gonna actually be pronating, okay? So you're gonna see how my racket is gonna be going upwards. You're gonna see these kind of strings going up, and then you're gonna see my racket turning, and then at the very end, you're gonna see my racket a little more towards the side before I finish the movement, okay? So I'm here, and that was a pretty bad slicer. You see, so you can see how I'm hitting, I'm pronating, and then I'm relaxing. I'll show you one more time here. Whoop, that's buttocks. So you can see how I'm hitting and going up, and then after that I'm just relaxing my arm and letting it go, okay? So guys, I hope that helped you out. Don't forget, like and subscribe our YouTube channel to help us out promoting it a little more on YouTube. We're gonna try to stay a little more active now. We've been super busy since we were able to get back into the court. We've been teaching so much on the court, but we're trying to get back, posting way more videos. So please, like and subscribe so you can help us out. You can push a little bit the channel, and we'll see you in the next video.